In this video, I want to talk about some of the themes that work beautifully with Beaver Builder, which is a page builder for WordPress websites. Now, it's important to note first that Beaver Builder will work with any theme. Now, when I'm talking about working with a theme, more specifically, I'm talking about having a full width row in the different page layouts. And so that's the difference. A lot of themes, Beaver Builder is going to work just fine. However, you won't get that full width where you can put an image in the background or a full width color and have these different sections going on your website. So that is what I'm talking about. Now, there's several themes available that you can already use perfectly with Beaver Builder. The first one would be the Beaver Builder theme. Now, the only drawback with the Beaver Builder theme, it's a phenomenal theme, amazing options, awesome development team. The only drawback is it's an extra $100, and then you have to pay a annual support renewal, update renewal fee on top of what you pay already for Beaver Builder. So now if you have the money, that's the way to go. Definitely the way to go is to pick up that Beaver Builder theme. But this video is just to explore other options that are out there outside of the Beaver Builder theme. Now, there's several themes that already work great. All the StudioPress themes, that's Genesis, and all the Genesis Child themes, they're going to work great. There's this little add-on plugin that you can get that is free, and it'll allow Beaver Builder to work with all those StudioPress themes. So if you already have Genesis from StudioPress and the Child theme package, they'll work perfectly. Another option is, and there's a couple of videos I've seen about it, and it's nicknamed Dynamic Beaver, and there's a really powerful child theme for StudioPress called Dynamic. I own Dynamic. It's a great theme. The only negative in my mind with Dynamic is there's tons and tons and tons and tons of settings, and it could be a little daunting. And so that's another option, and that's nicknamed Dynamic Beaver. And for this video, I'll nickname this Gen Beaver, and I want to tell you about another theme option, and that's called GeneratePress. Now, GeneratePress is one of the top themes that's free as well, and it's in the WordPress repository. So that means in your WordPress website, you can go to appearance themes, type GeneratePress, and you can install it immediately from your WordPress dashboard. Now, what's nice about GeneratePress, number one, it's a very light theme. It's very cleanly coded. There's a great support community behind it. I'm actually on their website here. So when you click on the support tab, there's this very full support community going on where a lot of people are asking questions and the developers engaged giving them answers. There's lots of code snippets. It's a great community to jump in on, and the theme is free. Now, what is also nice about this theme is the developer has a very affordable add-on pack that adds functionality to the theme. So I'm going to show you the add-on pack real quick, and then I'm going to go into the theme and show you why I think this is just a great option for anyone that's building websites with Beaver Builder. So first off, the add-on pack is just going to make some things a little easier, okay? So as you can see, the theme itself has been downloaded almost 600,000 times. So I'm going to click on this add-ons here. And so the add-on pack is only $39.95. It's a one-time fee. You can install it on all your sites. There's a licensing system where you can type in your license code and you'll get those automatic updates. But check this out. When you scroll down, you're going to get the ability to adjust colors, change all your fonts, add sections, but we won't be using sections really because we're going to use Beaver Builder for that. Some additional menu options. This one right here is really key, page header, and I'm going to show you what options you have to do in that header as far as putting images and videos into the header if you wanted. You can have the masonry layout on your blog. Let's see, the spacing is really important for adding and adjusting the different spacing between the elements. backgrounds copyright, and although if you're going to use the free theme, he'll give you the function to change the copyright. He's not one of those developers that have given you a free theme, but you realize it's filled with branding and all kinds of stuff that you wouldn't want. So anyways, but it's a real easier way of doing it is when you get the add-on pack. Here's something that's very interesting, and that's, let me back up. Disable elements, and what that allows you to do is disable certain elements on a page-by-page basis, and I'm going to show you this. You can disable the header, the footer, different things like that, and I'll show you what you can do with that. That's one of my favorite add-ons, by the way. I wish that was actually included in every theme. Right here is something that's very interesting, and that's hooks. And so you can, with Beaver Builder, you can create these Beaver Builder short codes and you can drop it in these hook areas, and it's very powerful. And then this import-export feature, that's actually really nice. This is going to allow you to import and export settings and different things like that. It's very powerful. So that's the add-on pack. I've got a link down below if you want to take a look at it. Oh, and let me, before I jump into the actual WordPress, let me show you the support form. You can see here there's almost 3,500 posts here of people asking questions, getting help, and the developer provides this all for free, which is pretty amazing. So anyways, here it is, and I'm calling this Gen Beaver. I'll be the first person to put the name on it. Now, I was talking with the developer about making it so out of the box this would work perfectly with the full width for Beaver Builder, and I think he did that, but prior to him releasing an update recently, I have this little snippet of code right here that I can give you, and this will remove all the padding in the margins if you're using Beaver Builder to put together your page layout. So this little snippet of code will do that, but I think he might have added that already into the CSS of the site. So let me just open it up in a new tab here and go to the home page. Now, this is the home page. I haven't built it out with Beaver Builder, but I just wanted to show you that really cool feature of the page header where you can choose an image and have it integrate into the navigation, and you'll have total control on these pages over the navigation colors, over everything really, and then you can start your Beaver Builder pages down here. So just to show you that, if I click on Page Builder, and I'll just leave it on blank, you can see I've got that full width row going on here. So if I wanted to add a column and then change the background color, so let's go ahead and change that to a color. All right. And then I could go up here and make it full width, and you could see you get that full width row with this theme, and that's one of the main benefits with it. So I can go ahead and click on save, and you can see we've got this nice full width row going on. So you get that with this theme. Now let me show you what it looks like on the page. So I'm in pages, and here's my home page. Now what you get is this page header section right here. You can put a static image. You can even put a video in there. That's pretty nice, and have an overlay color over that video. That's awesome. And then you can put some text in that area, and you have all these different settings as far as what the color of the text is going to be. So it'll look good on top of the video you're using, or good on top of the image that you're using. And then you have the advanced settings, and that's where you can merge that image or video with the site header, and you can change the color of the site title. And if I had a logo loaded in, I'd be able to change the logo to be a different color logo. Now you can do some of this already with the Beaver Builder theme, but it requires some custom CSS. And it doesn't have the options of changing the color of the logo or the text or any of that. So it's not as easy to accomplish. So right here, I wanted to show you this. One of my favorite things is the disable elements right here. So here's all these options, and I can check on any of these, and it will disable that element on this page. So it's a page-by-page basis. This is also something that you can do with the Beaver Builder theme. They have a different page template that will disable the header and the footer. But with this add-on pack, you can essentially do the same thing. You can decide, but you have a bit more power. So I could decide on this page, I don't want that navigation. So you might want to do that on a order page. If someone's ordering something on your website, they're on the order page, you don't want to give them an easy way out with more navigation options. So you can disable navigation items. And this is really awesome right here. You can also disable the content title. And there's a lot of times, especially with Beaver Builder, that you're going to want to have an easy way of disabling that title because you're probably going to not need it with the Beaver Builder page builder that you're, whatever page that you're building. And you have some stuff here as well with the post image and whatnot. It's so powerful, and you can also have control on a page-by-page basis of the footer widgets. You've got so many different page layout options. You can have the content, the sidebar. Well, these are actually kind of standard nowadays, but you have this option here. So when you actually click on this option here, content no sidebars, that's when that CSS is going to kick in and make the rows 100% and remove any margin or paddings that might be in the way. Now for the hooks, there's an area right here. So here's the hook area. You've got your before header content, and as you can scroll down, you can see all these hooks are here. And you can also put PHP in these different hook areas. So it will take a short code, which is nice. So with the Beaver Builder, you can create these templates. You can have an opt-in template, and you can put it in a hook, and it will dynamically appear across your site-wide. So you have these options here in this different hooks that they give you by default already with this theme. Now let's jump into the customizer and take a look there. Actually, before I do that, jump into the GeneratePress menu area here. So when you activate the add-on pack, here's where you can change your copyright. And this is something I'm sure a lot of people will appreciate. You get all these add-ons. It's one plugin installation, and then you can activate them on an add-on by add-on basis. So for instance, for me, if you're using Beaver Builder, you're not going to really need this sections add-on, but you have all these here. So if there was an add-on that you didn't want to activate, you really don't have to do that. You can come in here and just activate them, or just what you want and know you're going to use. So I'm going to go ahead and click on customize here, and we'll just take a quick look at the customizer and then wrap up this video. So you have your layout options are really nice. It gives you the option to select your page width, and I love that. And it's full of different options here. Here's your colors, of course. So that gives you full control over all your colors here in the customizer. Your blog header, and this is really cool. It's your element spacing. So you can easily go in here and set all your padding and spacing for all the different elements throughout your website. And even down here, you can even choose your sidebar width, and it's all just built in here to the customizer. Full topography options. And what I've noticed is on these different options that it gives you in this theme with the add-on pack, they actually give you more options than I would normally see. It's kind of like that dynamic theme where you get every different option possible, in literally every single option possible. This gives you a lot of options as well, but instead it's in the customizer, which makes it a little easier and more user-friendly. So you got your, of course, your Google fonts in here, and you can choose your weight, and you can do the text transform. I really like that. And so that's primarily what I wanted to look at in this video. Was the main features that I think make the GeneratePress theme, along with the paid add-ons really stand out. Now, you don't need at all to use their paid add-ons. You can use the free theme and give that a shot. You just need to know a little bit of CSS here or there. But for me, I think it's one of the best values in the WordPress ecosystem right now at only $40, and you get all this built into it, and you don't have to pay an annual update fee or anything like that. It's all just kind of built into it, but it's a really powerful combination. And so lastly, let me just throw in one of those new Beaver Builder templates for you. I did a video about a month ago showing you all the new templates that they added. So it would be easy to just go in here and pick a new template. How about this? We'll replace this layout. And you'll see now we've got the new Beaver Builder template in there looking beautiful because, like I said, you're getting these full width page sections. So offers a great starting point. Now, it's important to note that this theme combo is going to work great with the free Beaver Builder plugin that you can get out of the WordPress repository. It's great. But for me, I rather have the paid one because, number one, I want access to faster support. I like all the additional features that Beaver Builder gives me. If you want to find out more information about Beaver Builder's paid plugin, I've got a link as well down below. And as usual, whenever you're clicking on a link on my channel, most likely it's going to be an affiliate link. However, that's not why I talk about these different products. I talk about them because I'm using them myself. Right now I'm building something with GeneratePress and the free version of the Beaver Builder plugin. I'm building that for this channel, so you'll be able to see that coming up here real soon. Well, that's it for today's video. I'd love to hear your thoughts on it in the comment section down below. Please also give me a thumbs up on YouTube. That really helps me out. And if you haven't subscribed yet to the channel, go ahead and click on that subscribe button. That also helps me out. Now, I don't want you to ever leave empty-handed, and that's why I've put together a free video course just for my subscribers called The 3 Steps to WordPress Success. Now, if you would like free access to that course, just go ahead and click right here on the right. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.